is Rudge, one of the things that comes up with you is one of the first things, because so Willow moving over to the settlement over here, I believe that took like a day or two with the entire, you know, settlement and your tri-horns and stuff.
Yep.
Rudge, you're heading south along the road, and traveling, you're flying, right?
Yep. Well, like I got my truck too.
Oh yeah, you got your truck.
Yep, I got
so
my...
Are you driving the...
Yep, I was driving that and floating it when I need to, I remember now.
Okay. Yep, so you're... Just give me a drive roll for the lulls.
Mm-hmm. That's a lull, all right. Okay, let's see. Yeah.
I think on this game, my drive check, the drive checks are definitely my favorite thing because they're so unpredictable.
Yep.
37 out of...
Okay, you know, I mean... Yeah, that's still a fail, but it's not... It's not terrible.
Yep.
Like
that's why I have powers. I don't care.
Like you probably you're driving at the skill of like, you know, a person playing a racing game with a keyboard and mouse.
A high schooler.
Oh,
yeah. Unfamiliar with the controls.
Imagine if a high schooler got to drive like a military vehicle.
Yep.
Or imagine trying to drive your car with a keyboard and mouse.
Yep. Yeah, that's about what I'm doing. It's not working out.
Yeah. So, I mean, like, it doesn't hinder you that much with your powers. And you think you're doing pretty well, all things considered, with this primitive barbarian technology.
Yep.
It takes you about a little longer than it takes Willow and the rest of the group to get to the new campsite, to get down to Roswell. But as you are heading down, I would like both you and Zero to make perception rolls for me.
Okay. Fucker. I decided, because I rolled two dice at the same time, and just pick a color for Rudge, and I should have picked the other one. 9 for Rudge, and 19 for... Zero. Poncho.
19 for Poncho. Yeah. Okay. Oh, that's perfect. I moved you over onto the Roswell map because this is about when... you're like in sight of the northernmost dome here, which to refresh since it has been a while since we've looked at this map.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I don't even recognize this map.
Yeah, I don't. It's very briefly we looked at it. So there's the main tower, the Temple of the Travelers here, in the bottom right, which is where Dawnspire is. And this is like a flying saucer, like disc. I think there's an image of it in the handouts.
Yeah, in the notes. By the way, I don't think Rudge ever saw this, actually.
Nope.
Okay.
Anytime Rudge has been here, it's been very briefly, so we didn't pull.
Right. Yeah. So we never actually got the map out. Yeah. So. Yeah, it's like the tower in the handout, except for it's like matte black and a little bit smoother and sleeker.
Okay.
But that general style. And then these three other domes are like dormant versions of that tower that are just like domes that are about 100 feet tall.
Oh shit.
A couple hundred feet tall. I mean, they're still like really big. Like to put this in perspective, this thing is a half a mile in diameter, so it's freaking huge. Each one of them. This I have no idea what the hell that is. Some kind of vague plan for something I would imagine.
So that was where me and Titanus were digging. Yep, because the circle in the center is where it all kind of combined.
Yeah, so you determined that there was some kind of central, like, reservoir or underground.
Yep, and the squiggly is the path that Willow took.
Okay, you were, like, doing a...
Yeah, where she's digging through the ground and plasma form. Yeah.
Yeah.
So there's theoretically exposed pipeline there.
I believe it was like here.
I think we covered it up actually.
Yeah, I think you did. But yep. that was like the general location of where you did it.
Yep.
Anyways, yeah, this is not important anymore. But yeah, so that's you the general layout. Also, this area is like the farmland that Dawnspire uses. So yeah, you are already familiar with this area as you passed through it, and you are an intelligent person who is good with maps.
Yay.
So you're driving here. You're pretty close to Dawnspire. Maybe like 20 minutes away at most. And,
I was up top.
You're just sort of passing by the first tower here. Yep. When Zero, it says, sir, we got a unidentified aircraft off to the east.
Again.
And you kind of like, after Zero's drawn attention to it, you see there is what appears to be a trio of sky cycles, sort of like running vaguely towards your position.
All right. Son of a bitch. Okay, I shrink that. I get out, shrink the car down.
Mm-hmm.
Put it in the bay of holding.
Yep.
And hide, I guess. I'm assuming they have thermals, so could I like do like a cold screen again?
You could. That they would probably see the cold screen visually.
Yeah,
you had some kind of. There are like some ruined building or like.
Yeah. I guess I don't know what kind of time frame I have.
You have a very short amount of time.
Okay, then if there's really nothing.
A minute. Okay. There are some like small shacks and stuff you could like hide in.
Yeah, I'll ask the little shack and kind of make it cold inside.
Okay. Yep. So there's like faint dry ice sort of vapor coming out of the cracks of the shack.
Mm-hmm.
But better than heat signature. And you hear the sort of hum as the bikes fly over and do a couple of passes. After a few minutes, they move onwards.
All right. IQ 23. I can hide from technology.
Good thing that Zero rolled so high.
Yeah, I know.
A good window.
Exactly. If it would have been me, I would have just been, and they're landing above you.
Yep.
Oh, no.
It's like, hello.
Yep. I would have been shot, I think. But, all right. Thank you. Thank you, Poncho. That was a good... good censorship.
Censorship. all right.
I missed it. I was busy driving this pile.
How would you like to proceed?
I'll just float for a while.
Okay.
I'll do a 20 mile an hour low hover.
Give me a D100 roll.
Okay. Where's my tenor? Hiya! Oh boy, 66.
66. Alright.
If I had another die, it'd be a 6. I know it. It'd be 666, because that's what's coming at me.
So you continue on down this way, and you get to sort of like the developed road that. Sort of comes out of Dawnspire. Mm-hmm. And have more cover in the buildings here. And after when you get like maybe a mile or two down the road, you hear the sound of like helicopter rotors.
What?
Coming from the west.
Oh, shit. Like, do I know that if Dawnspire has fucking tech like this?
They don't have any aircraft as far as
I didn't think so. That's why I dipped immediately with the Sky Cycles. I'm like, nope, the only one I know who has that is Coalition. And then same thing with the helicopter. The only one I've seen is Coalition.
Yep.
How far away are they? Like, I just hear it?
You hear it coming from the west, because you're in the sort of, like, city street area, so your line of sight is a little bit limited, more limited.
God damn it. I don't know. I mean, I'll try and hide again. And if it doesn't work, okay. I'm bringing that helicopter down.
Are you doing the same?
Yeah, I'm gonna find something. Thing. I'm gonna find something again, like metal, if I can, if I have.
Yeah.
You know.
I mean, they're mostly like concrete buildings.
What? Yeah,
like,
that's as good, because I'm assuming it's like a foot of concrete.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, I get in a building and make a little cold hole.
Okay. So it's another charge of your suit.
I know.
But the helicopter goes by. Actually, with your sensors like looking out, there are three smaller attack helicopters in like a V formation.
Shit. This is close. Like two Dawnspire.
Yeah.
Dawnspire.
they fly over you. Without stopping.
Alright. Yeah, I'm not messing with communications or nothing. Like, I'm not calling out or, like, trying to radio ahead. Because I'm close, right? I'm, like, right up. Oh, yeah. What do we have? Five-mile range?
5 miles. There, yeah, about, I think.
Okay, well.
For personal radios.
Yeah, even if I get within range, I'm not going to, because they could be scanning. All right, this sucks. I tell Poncho. They are in full effect on patrol or some shit.
So you continue on more carefully than before, and you get within like a mile of the Dawnspire. Like, you can see the tower. And this is an area that is a little bit more open. Just like sort of coming out of the old ruins of the city. You kind of get a sight of the farm area.
Okay. So I see that there's a mile stretch that's kind of open.
It's not super, like, there's still cover. It's just not like dense city.
Okay.
So there are stretches of open ground that you'd have to go across.
Okay.
But something you see as you sort of get to the edge of that, looking out this way, in like the field area, there are a couple of helicopters landed sort of like generally around each other, and there seems to be like a small encampment out there.
Oh boy. So they're here.
It's definitely nice. Coalition.
Yeah, they are here, and they've been already probably dealing with these people. Like, talking with them or something. Something's happening on the inside. All right, yeah, so I look, do a big old zoom and try and see if there's... Basically do some scouting, like some enemy tagging.
Okay. Yeah, just kind of like look
at.
So just judging by, just give me a general.
I'm sensor man.
D100 roll.
I'm sensor man. I can see everything over there. I can see who's inside the helicopters. I can see how many dudes are just sitting around smoking cigarettes. 26.
26%?
Yep. Yep.
Okay.
It's a 6, not a 9.
Nice. All right, so there are, of the helicopters there, those three are all the, like, carrier-type helicopters, okay. The Black Lightning. They're, the ones that you saw before were smaller, more like attack helicopters.
Yeah.
So that means there's at least six helicopters and three scout cycles, or rocket cycles, whatever the fuck they're called.
Sky cycles.
Yeah, one of those words.
And three attack choppers.
So it seems like a force of scouting, like squads that is a little bit bigger than any of them that you've seen before, but like definitely not a like an assault team.
Okay.
But they do have like Samaz armor and like pretty much all of the coalition units that you have fought up to this point, just like more.
So there's guys over there.
Yeah.
Like a whole bunch of them.
There's a couple of like pilots and troopers and like power armor. The troopers seem to be like scout, specked out with scout. Like a lot of them have jetpacks and like scoped rifles and stuff.
Oh man, yeah, that's cool. That's kind of what Gary wanted to do.
So they're like the recon force.
All right. So shit. So there's power armor, jetpack guys, troopers, soldiers, pilots.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So a little force. Okay, now how the fuck do I get in? Or do I even want to? I think I might just want to fucking leave. I mean, I'm here. I want to find out what's going on. I don't know how hard it's going to be to get into this place without raising alarm. Do they know what we look like? Coalition.
I don't
think so.
I think that you've ever like taken your helmet off around any.
But do they know? They know our description, our armor, I suppose.
They know your armor. Yeah.
Okay.
At least you could assume that that knowledge is. It might. Well, no, because the soldiers you interrogated mentioned that like their commanding officer was like familiar with what you guys look like.
Okay, look like.
So they were armor, looks
okay,
like.
Okay.
They were briefed on you based on the knowledge the coalition has about you from the Amarillo incident.
Shit. Yeah, they'll know me immediately. This shit stands out. Damn it. All right, I look around on the walls and stuff. Is this an open, like, is this big walls and then open, or is it dome?
Tonspire?
Yeah.
There is a, like, a stretch of ground that's, like, open in between the walls and, like, the rest of everything, you know, as you do with walls, so.
Yeah.
Any approaching force doesn't have any cover.
Okay. I'm just wondering, like, can I get in without being seen by, like, guards and whatnot?
By, like, the Dawnspire guards, or by the coalition
at the moment, like with what I
see. if you skirted around out in like this direction,
yeah,
a ways,
yeah,
like the people over here would probably not be able to see you.
All right, I'm gonna go do that.
Okay,
I'm gonna get in with as minimal sight as possible, but if Dawnspire guard sees me, then I will approach them, you know, and go from there.
Mm-hmm.
I'll, like, hate them and whatnot.
Okay. Give me another prowl roll. D100.
Okay, that's what I'm rolling. Oh! No! Oh, you cocksucker! Had to go under the fucking... How far did it go? Okay, that's not bad. I thought I'd have to move the table to get at that one. Oh, it was so close to 40. Now it's a 60. 62.
Okay, so you're sneaking as best as you can as being Rudge.
Right.
And not knowing how to do
that. Yep, this is the Rudge Trudge.
Yep. So yeah, you're sort of floating around or like walking around, heading in with more of a mind to stay out of the side of the Coalition than of the Dawnspire guards. You do see several like figures on the wall, and after like you sort of get within sight of the wall over here, like it looks like they spotted you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so
like one of them sort of like points a rifle to like inspect you.
Yep. Can I zoom to tell if it's Dawnspire to make sure?
Yes. Okay. You zoom in. You see the like, they like yellow and black sort of sun iconography of their painted armor. All so right. Yes. Dawnspire troops.
I put up like the two hand wave and like I'm then started walking at those guys.
Okay. So you just walk towards the wall.
Yep. And now, damn it. What's my jamming communications capabilities? Is it just broad like crazy?
Like what do you mean broad?
I turn it on and it just jams in like the whole area, maximum vicinity. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
you could probably tune it down to be like a smaller area, but it does jam like all devices. What is the area of the jammer? Yeah.
Oh shit! Let me look.
Do you have that written down?
Possibly. Let's see, transmitter. Nope, I gotta find that. I'll have to get that.
Okay. Well, yeah, with a skill roll, you could tune it to
okay.
Be a reduced area.
Because they're definitely radioing to someone that there is someone out here, and I just don't want that knowledge to get back to a Coalition unit.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll try a skill roll and do a very short range block. Just trying to get the guys on the wall, and then obviously it's gonna hit some other people, but whatever.
Okay, sure.
Okay, skill roll. Man, the dice love those 60s. What am I doing? What's radio? Radio basic or? Let's see. Yeah, I guess that's all I really have is radio basic.
I'd say your radio basic at like a minus 15%, just because.
Okay. Still got it.
Okay. Yeah, so you turn on the jammer and kind of fiddle with it a little bit as you approach the wall. The lookout on the wall sort of, like, as you start walking towards him, makes sort of like a beckoning gesture, like, hurry up.
Yep, I do. Big old armor steps.
Yep. So you get up to the wall and fly up the wall, I presume.
Yeah, yeah. Well, okay. I grapple.
Oh, okay. Yeah, right. You have a grappling hook.
Yep. I have to put up some. I use tech as much as I can.
Right. Yep. Yeah. So you get up the wall and the lookout there sort of as he sees you. Like nods and says, "Welcome, Star Angel. I did not expect to see you, but I am glad that you are here."
Ah, good. I'm glad that you recognize me. You haven't tried to radio anyone about my approach, have you?
I tried to. He says, "I radioed Captain Phoenix."
Okay.
But I think I got cut off.
Yes, that was me. I wanted to make sure no Coalition forces intercepted your call.
Oh, good. I was worried that there might be something happening or someone pursuing you.
No. So, what is the situation? And bring me to whoever is not under Coalition eyes that can, you know, get me up to speed and, yeah.
Okay, so you, as you're sort of like saying that, you see one of the like, one of the vehicles they have, sort of like Jeep type things, pulls up on the side of the wall, and Captain Phoenix steps out and sort of like waves you down.
All right. I hop down.
And you get inside the vehicle to see like there are a handful of like citizens with like patchwork armor, as well as a pair of dog boys sort of like sitting in the van with a bunch of like different kinds of weapons and munition. Mm-hmm. Captain Phoenix says,
welcome, Star Angel. I'm glad you are able to get through to us in the midst of
this. All that? Yes, it's crazy out there.
Yes, well, it's only going to get worse. We made contact with them about a day ago. They hailed our radio tower, and we did not invite them in as politely as possible. And they have been somewhat sieging us for the past day.
How so?
They are patrolling around the edge of our walls, out of line of sight. Well, not from the top of the tower, and not from radar, but they're making sure that none of us leave and no one comes in.
Oh, great. Now I have a task getting out.
It seems they are waiting, or perhaps just keeping an eye on us until they have reinforcements.
Ah. Well, shit. It seems that they are intent on taking this place?
We shall see. As of right now, I've made sure that we have only shown our human residents on the walls and invisible range, and as you guys are driving through, you see that Dawnspire streets seem fairly deserted. It definitely seems like a city during wartime. Mm-hmm. Like, all the houses, like, the windows are boarded up, and the citizens that are walking through the streets are armed and have...
It's pretty much a militia in the streets.
Like, patchwork armor. Yeah. Yeah, so you have, like, the guard, who actually have, like, real armor and military training, who are on the walls.
Okay.
And then, like, it's just, like, militia in the streets.
All right. So, yeah, this escalated fairly quickly, then. They didn't,
we are
waste any time.
Preparing for the worst and hoping for the best. Hmm. But the travelers will see us through, I have faith. The tower has shown us yet more secrets, and...
Yes, it seems I will never get the time I want with that tower. I came down here for more experimentation. I never got a chance to
do
all the things I could do, and you said new things are happening.
There are, of course, there's little that you can do on this siege front. I would recommend, indeed, that you head to the tower. Our Dr. Torres is there this moment, attempting to decipher the secrets of the travelers. But perhaps your connection to them may help.
Possibly. That's. I hope there's enough time. Unveiling cosmic secrets isn't. Well, it can happen instantly, I suppose. But.
He just kind of like smiles and nods and like puts a hand on your shoulder and says, "The travelers will guide you." I'm sure of that.
All right. I guess. I will be most likely, so Mike's asking, what was our plan again? Am I leaving here to come back, or are you coming down here to meet me?
I do believe it was spend as much time as you want down there, because Willow has, like, theoretically she has a very long time worth of work to do.
Mm-hmm.
So as much time as you want to spend down there, Willow had no plans of leaving anytime soon, because she has, like, plans to basically get her military in order if need be.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So that's what I mean. It's, but now, was that under the, not assumption, but like just under the knowledge of that we had at the time of that, that they weren't here yet and I had like more time to be here? Or
I'm sorry. We had not discussed that probably. Mm-hmm. I mean, worst case scenario. I mean,
because eventually they might come in and.
Yeah, I mean, Willow is just going to assume you're down there doing research, and she knows her research can take months, if not years, so you being gone for a long time would not be noticed by her.
Okay, so I'd have to come back.
You would, like, if the your guys' settlers get their radio equipment set up again, yep. It's possible that you could get a radio message between the two places.
Yeah, exactly. And that's probably what we are waiting on, is for us to...
Yeah. Because Dawnspire has a pretty well-established radio tower, as you might imagine. Mm-hmm. A giant freaking alien monolith is a pretty good place to put a radio transponder.
Mm-hmm. I mean, they have a few good towers around here.
Yep. All right, so with that situation established, we will jump back over to Willow.
Yep.
So, Willow, let's see here. You guys get to this, the ruins of an unnamed city over here, which your people have been salvaging for metal and other resources for the past couple, month and a half. So they're fairly familiar with the streets and are fairly confident that it's safe. So where is you sort of head over, and the like I said, the western side of the city is sort of being slowly overtaken by nature again, with like small trees and like shrubs everywhere.
Yep.
And that side, sort of like where the buildings meet the forest, is where you guys want to set up camp.
Yes. Plan was to build an actual military grade structure into the
ruins.
We were going to do like more kind of like into this area where it's like natural cover is going to exist.
Yeah, so there are buildings in here. They're more sparse. This area right here, this little like sort of tongue, if you can see that.
Yeah.
There's like a riverbed that goes along here. That is the area that's sort of like lightly forested and ruined buildings. But if you want to go with a more like forest with like more forest than buildings, as to for more buildings than forest.
Yeah, we wanted to go. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna design a single structure to be like a military fortification. Like a retreat area.
Yep.
And then after that building is set up, then we're going to do small structures out in the main city-ish area.
Okay.
I would be perfectly okay with letting people choose wherever they want to live and help them build up a building wherever, because this is presumably going to be a final home for them, assuming they don't have to run away again.
Right.
So I'm not going to tell them where they can and cannot build, but we will build like a small guard tower directly out from where the military building is.
Mm-hmm. As it stands right now, the settlers definitely understand the severity of the situation, and they're very much in like circle the wagons mode.
Yep.
Like stay close together, especially in unfamiliar territory.
Yep.
So you do actually find like right here, there is the ruins of like a cluster of larger buildings that might have been some kind of like school or like a church or something, maybe.
Yeah, that would work.
Like one of those big old mega church type things.
Yeah, I mean, as long as it's not like the whole point of this building was to be like not seen from the sky, aka sky cycles.
Yep.
So as long as it's got some coverage, that would work perfectly.
Or yeah, even... so
I mean, if they wanted to do like a community living thing inside that thing, and then us just build a structure elsewhere, that's fine.
So the main buildings are a little bit more visible, but they are most definitely ruins.
Yeah.
So with the like various military knowledge people that you have, you could definitely design a structure to be like, you're going for more of like a bunker type thing, right?
Correct.
So you could definitely design something that like fits into the ruined buildings, benefiting from their like structure and their like basements and stuff.
Yeah.
Without being obvious.
Yeah. I mean, that's what we'd be going for.
Okay. And then there's plenty of trees around for Willow to disguise her metal trees amongst them to the casual observer.
Perfect.
Until
one day she can have a world forest.
Yep. So, yeah, you sort of get there and survey the surrounding landscape, and Dusty and Titanus and Willoughby sort of start planning out the defenses, and they're the military people.
Yep.
Whereas Willow, I'm assuming, is focusing more on her manufacturing stuff.
Correct.
What is Willow's first step here with the?
So the very first thing she's gonna do is as soon as like those guys start getting to work on like the structural stuff, she's gonna probably stop communicating with anybody, because she's gonna go like basically tell everyone what her plans are. And it's going to be, she's going to plant those trees immediately.
Yep.
And the moment they are planted and, you know, they actually grow to the point she can use them, she's going to start pumping out drones to begin with.
Yeah. Okay.
And basically what her entire first process is going to be is getting a handful of drones that can actually be active guards 24/7 without requiring sleep. So what she's going to do is pump out, where's my little list here? So she's going to start with the Earth Defender drones. Yeah, so I have a full list of all the drones that she'll eventually make.
Mm-hmm.
Depending time-wise and everything like that, she'll fill up her full 31 slots. And that'll cost a total of 5,100 pounds.
Okay. Yeah. Million. Nice. That's actually not that much.
No, that's the thing. Out is of like
your total.
No, I mean like the thing is her drones are all like, you know, general humanish weight, so it's right. Not like ridiculous.
Yeah.
And then once her drones are in a good spot, she might even like halfway through stop and build one of the patrol cars.
Okay.
Which is, you know, 2.5 tons.
Yeah. So we have written down here, if you're going to make all the seeds and then plant them, it's going to take about a week for the amount of metal, doing, I think, 10,000 pound trees, right?
Yep.
5 ton trees.
Yep.
So if you wanted to like get the drones out first, you could like make one tree and then make the drones.
That's probably what she would do first.
Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, because that'll definitely much more securely cement your position here. With like 31 more troops. So if you want to go ahead and give me a mechanical engineering role for the manufacturing, definitely have enough time. But we'll just see how much time it takes to actually make them. Are you guys still there?
Oh, sorry. Am I?
Oh, I am muted. Wow, that's
okay.
Was I rolling mechanical? I thought that was.
No, that was Will.
Okay. So I rolled a 7.
7. Nice. Yeah, 7. Okay. So that is really good. Because that's your role for the week, which Let's see. That so you can do 20 tons worth of manufacturing this week, okay, which is so much.
Yes, that is.
I would say that means so like 2.5 tons. You basically didn't slow down your seed planting much at all. By making all those, basically you created a tree and then you were able to make the.
She went full Willow mode.
Yep.
Like what is interacting with other people?
Buckle down, do not eat, do not sleep.
Yep.
And yeah, so yeah, you pump out the drones in like a day or two, and then continue to grow your metal garden. So the drones that you have planned up from that 5,100, you can add those to forces if you want. That seems like a good place to keep track of.
Yeah, I have my own thing here too, so I should be able to remember as well,
just
in case I ever forget to update this thing.
Yeah.
Okay. And then, are we including the vehicle in that, or just the drones?
You might as well include the vehicle. I guess you could put it in another...
I mean, there's a vehicle spot here, too.
Yep.
I just want to make sure, as you said, like, up to 20 tons, and, like, that would be well within the range to do at least one of the
vehicles. Oh, yeah.
Within the same tree.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because that's still... You only used, like, half the tree.
Yep.
That you
and she'd probably purposely leave the other half of the tree to make sure, emergency situation, she could throw something else out.
In case you needed to, like... Whip up some guns real quick or something.
Yeah, I mean, like, I'm working on a full list of everything. I have a pretty good know-how of what I'm going to be doing overall. So, it's just going to come down to the time.
Yep.
Okay, so... Actually, I'm just going to do... Can we do tables in this? We might be able to. I might be able to save myself a ton of time here. Come on. Yes. Let's see if that. There we go. The table actually works. Good.
Yay.
That makes so much more easy.
Oh, yeah. There you go.
So that is what I have. So I have a total of I currently only have the what is it? The two complex drones. I have one Skywing and then one Earth Defender. And so essentially the Earth Defender is gonna be like the general around town that's gonna be controlling the actual drones that are in town.
Yep, so you got the Watchers are the like
little helicopter kind of thing.
Yeah, the little, like, drones.
Yep, they're the ones that are basically designed to be cameras.
Mm-hmm.
They have little guns on them, but they're not going to engage in combat. Their primary goal is to report what they see.
Okay. And the Earth Defenders are equivalent of, like...
Like heavy armor with a big gun.
Heavy troopers.
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, that's... That definitely beefs up your defenses.
Yeah, and so... Like, once Willow's done making them, she'd probably introduce them to everybody as, like, one big, like, momentous occasion. And she'd make it very clear that anybody that's uncomfortable with the drones, she'll keep them, steer clear from them. Because, like, that's got to be unnerving for some people.
Yeah, there's definitely a couple of the, like, the Frontiers people, like, their only exposure to advanced technology like this is the Coalition.
Yeah, and I mean, and the fact that Willow did this in, like, a week is probably fucking terrifying.
Yeah, like, super unnerving. Like, where did they come from?
So she'll make it very clear that anybody that's not comfortable with it, she will steer clear of the drones.
Okay.
Like, she'll keep the drones out of their area.
I will point out, the soldiers, the 9 soldiers you have are very happy with this, because...
Yeah, and so, actually...
More firepower on their side.
Exactly. So the primary thing that she did was she made 10 of the or 9 of the menial Earth Defender drones. That's going to essentially be a 1-for-1 for the soldiers we have. Like, if they're ever out and they want a drone to follow, it'll follow.
Okay. Yep, so they got a buddy.
They have somebody that will literally sacrifice itself to keep them alive, so...
Nice.
It's very important to note that the human lives are far more important than the drones.
Yeah. Drones can be repaired. Humans can be repaired, but it's more difficult, and the doctor is out.
Yeah, and they got nine soldiers, right? And because we have nine soldiers, it's actually pretty much the exact same route. So it'll be nine Earth Defenders to our nine soldiers, and we have 10 Watcher drones. So there'll be essentially a handful that'll be flying around town in the woods and whatnot, but the rest will be out on patrols with people, keeping guard. The Skywing, the Wasp guys, are specifically for Willow and herself. So as scary as it would be to the people, they're just going to be haunting the woods.
Right.
Like, they are guardians of the world.
Giant wasps.
With missiles.
Giant missile wasps.
Yeah, so they will do everything to never be seen by people. Their primary goal is just going to be to watch the woods and make sure there's no dickheads sneaking in from the western, northern, or southern side. with the exception of the one that's a complex drone, of course, which would be traveling around talking to people commonly.
Of course.
And then the complex Earth Defender drone, he is going to be acting like general side by side with Titanus and Dusty, because that is, of course, you know, an extension of Willow. If there is any kind of battle, he'll be frontline.
What's the Skywing complex drone?
That's the one that's just, it just, it'll just travel around talking to people while Willow's busy with stuff, making sure everyone's doing okay.
Sounds good.
That's the one that'll probably be, if anything, commanding the Watcher drones frequently.
Mm-hmm.
Because Willow can technically get imagery from them because they are still machines, you know?
Yeah.
It just takes some thought from one of the drones, so.
All right.
It's basically acting like a router.
Yeah.
For Willow. That's the one that'll be sending its consciousness out to keep an eye on stuff visually. And there will be one Watcher drone designed for that's just going to stick around the main building. So it'll basically act as a 24-hour surveillance camera around the building.
Right.
So...
Okay. You get those up, and it takes a little bit of time for the people to acclimate to the new security. But for the most part, it's like better to have more things to in the way of death.
Yep.
And after the patrols, after about a day, looking at the information that you get from the patrols, it looks like there are some, you know, like little monsters and stuff in the, you know, it's rift, so there's some monsters in the forest around. They are driven off pretty readily if they encounter any of the drones. So for the time being, your position looks secure, and based on what you've seen, you're fairly confident that like this force could deal with most like random stuff that wanders by a place like this.
Okay.
Like, you didn't even have too much trouble, although this definitely seems to be like more dangerous.
It's wilderness, yeah.
Yeah, it's more wilderness than your little position, your little settlement out on the plains.
Yep.
One thing you do notice, this would be a little bit later in the timeline. Yeah. Willow's probably going to be ahead of Rudge time-wise for most of this. Mm-hmm. We'll hold off on that and jump back to Rudge for a little bit.
Sounds good.
And then we'll get to the next sort of Willow's bit after that. think that works better.
That's good.
Yep, so Rudge, jumping back over to you, as you, you sort of just arrived, and Captain Phoenix has briefed you on the situation surrounding Dawnspire, the siege and the like. And the vehicle that you guys are in drives up to this elevator here, up to the tower, and Captain Phoenix says, yes, the, as I said, the interior chambers of the temple have, there have been two more larger chambers that have appeared. I believe that one of them was already present upon your last visit, but a third appeared not a couple hours after the coalition forces made contact, and it seems to be some kind of central room. It's below the main chamber.
Oh.
I believe Dr. Torres seems to think it's some kind of control room.
Really?
But wow. Doesn't seem to be very many controls, as far as I can tell.
Well, let's go figure out what these things do.
He sort of nods and says, I imagined you would be interested in that. I have, of course, my duties patrolling the walls and ensuring that our coalition friends do not try anything. But I wish you luck on your scientific endeavors.
Yes, and be vigilant and don't let any of those bastards in.
He sort of nods sharply and then gets back into his vehicle, which he seems to be like patrolling around with. Mm-hmm. Going to the hot points. And yeah, you're let up the elevator into the upper disc of Dawnspire, which, looking up here, as said before, they've fortified like the upper ring and made it into a sort of like a fallback point. Well, Rudge probably wouldn't go up there, I imagine, with the allure of science.
I have
shit. But yeah, it looks like they're fortified and ready for a siege, and like able to retreat the city up there. As you saw before. Mm-hmm. The people at the elevator, which should be noted, are not the like Dawnspire soldiers. They're just like a single trooper, mm-hmm. or like a single militia man operating the elevator. You get up to the top, and the militia on the elevator says, if you're looking for Dr. Torres, you would want to go to the main chamber and then down the ramp. Right. Yes.
Thank you. I'm off.
Certain. So you make your way through the hallways of this strange place. Mm-hmm. Stark, like, black walls of this miraculous material. And you head down to the main chamber, which you remember is, like, it's the area that Father Castor sort of talked to people in most. It has, like, four pillars in this, like, fairly large circular room. Okay. And there is, like, a small sort of pedestal type thing, just like a protrusion from the floor in the middle, which has now been replaced by a sharp sort of corkscrewing ramp that goes down.
Cool.
And
I descend.
As you descend down, it is like pretty steep, and you kind of expect it to be slippery, mm-hmm. Just because like it's a metal ramp. But it has a surprising amount of traction for what it is. And actually, you would probably observe this because you have an attention for detail, and a scientific interest in such things. The ramp is actually like, it has like ridges on it and bumps, textured to make it like a little bit more, a little more friction to it. Mm-hmm.
Die cast, whatever.
Yep.
Those little grooves and things.
Yeah, they're more like little bumps, I guess, than mm-hmm. grooves. Okay. But yeah, more texturing than you've seen on most of the other surfaces in the tower.
All right, meant to be walked down.
Yep. So you get down the ramp, and it sort of comes to the edge of a another circular chamber. Which you see, there are a handful of, there's like a computer station set up and like a microscope and a couple of other like sensory, like scientific sensory equipment and stuff from Dr. Torres's lab. And you see her sort of hunched over the computer, which is sitting next to a this big hemispherical dome that dominates the center of this room. Mm-hmm. And other than that, it seems to be pretty much empty. Its walls are slightly curved. So it's like the inside of like a big sort of ellipse, almost like mirroring the outside of the saucer.
Okay.
In shape. And as you approach and sort of look around, you see that the dome has these like intricate patterns embossed onto them. There's like a bunch of sort of geometric, like Tetris pieces, basically, that are like carved into it with cryptic symbols across them.
So,
which are very hard to see with the human eye. Like, it's faint, like, scratches almost into the surface. You're only really able to see them because of your sensor, man.
Yes, haha.
You have both. Yeah. and Dr. Torres doesn't even really acknowledge you when you enter.
I do the same thing. I just go right into like looking at things.
So it's a couple of minutes before she notices your presence, and you hear kind of like a sudden shift of movement, like she jumped a little bit. Mm-hmm.
I probably did it when I talked to Zero.
Yeah, you're like, what do you make of this, Zero? I'm just like, shit. Yeah. So she sort of turns around and says, you. Mm-hmm. Rudge, was it?
Yes, it is. And it's you. How are you?
Busy. Mm. Trying to decipher the mysteries of this place with a ticking clock.
Yes, it seems we have much less time than anyone would have wanted. Well, I'm here to help. I actually was coming here to do what I could to learn the mysteries of this thing myself.
Sort of like looks at you third, or sort of normal, like measured look, and then nods and says, I must admit the help is appreciated. I do not believe that the Coalition will allow this city to exist in any way similar to what it is now, if and when they discover the nature of this tower.
and I do not want to imagine what things they could accomplish should they manage to harness the power contained within this technology.